Hi, everybody, from down on the field here at First Energy Stadium, where you can still feel the heat from that Browns defense and specifically their pass rush. They were the key to the Browns beating the Chicago Bears and going to 2-1, the final score, 26-6. This was not easy. That Bears defense is a tough defense to move against, and the Browns offense found that out, especially in the first half. But the Browns defense, which was challenged by Myles Garrett all week long, he told his mates, especially up front along that defensive line, hey, let's go. Let's start getting to the quarterback. How about 9 sacks of the rookie Justin Fields? And how about the individual performance by Garrett himself? He had 4.5, a career high for him, and he set a Browns team record, eclipsing the one previously held by the great linebacker Andre Davis. An amazing day for the Browns defensively. The secondary, which I thought had been playing too far off people, they were all over people in this game. A tough day for the former Buckeye, Justin Fields, in his debut as the Bears starter. He simply couldn't get anything going, and that's because of an offensive line that's really not up to snuff, but that Browns defense, which was all over him, and that pass rush was in his pocket and in his lap all afternoon long. But this was a tight game. It really was. 3-3 going near halftime, and the Browns went on a big drive right before the first half came to an end, led by Baker Mayfield, with Kareem Hunt making plays with his legs and with his hands down the field, and then Mayfield hit Austin Hooper with a touchdown pass that gave the Browns a 10-3 lead at the half with 19 seconds left to go in the first half. And in the second half, they just wore the Bears defense down. How did they do it? They did it with Kareem Hunt. Most days it's Nick Chubb. On this day, it was the hometown Brown, Kareem Hunt. He was amazing, catching the football, running the football. He had 158 total yards of offense in the game and a touchdown that put the game away on a thrilling run from 29 yards out on a 3rd-and-3 that said so long to the Bears and dropped them to 1-2. And you know something? All of a sudden around this town and definitely inside this stadium and definitely with this football team, they expect to win. That's how good they are as they go to 2-1 now and they hold serve at home. Kevin Stefanski, in only his second year as the Browns head coach, is now 8-2 at games played here at First Energy Stadium. I have to give a tip of the hat to the Browns kicker, Chase McLaughlin. He was great. 4 field goals in the game, one of them from 57 yards out. An amazing kick that at the time was important because it tied the game up at 3-3. He had another kick of over 50, 52 yards, and then added 2 more. Chase McLaughlin, if we were wondering about him, wonder no longer. He was exceptional in this game against Chicago. So the Browns now head on the road for the next 2 weeks. First things first, though, off to Minnesota to take on the Vikings, Kevin Stefanski's old team. So you have that storyline and a big welcome back to Odell Beckham Jr. He was back. He was good. Did he play on a pitch count? Absolutely not. He played all the way, and he made some exceptional catches in the game. 5 grabs, a lot of them very difficult catches. He looks like he is ready to go, and now we can build on this. But the worry through the first 2 weeks was that Browns defense, and right now they're starting to get it. They really played dominating defense on this Sunday, which propels the Browns to a huge win over the Chicago Bears, the final 26-6. Cleveland off to the Vikings coming up next week. For WKYC.com, I'm Jim Donovan.